morning. It's September 15th, a glorious morning to move a historic building. I'm here with Jim Swartzbauer, the president of Historic Society. And I'm Paul Winship with Craig Kojard. We became involved with Jim at the annual dinner last year. We're volunteering a foundation design, site design. We surveyed the path of travel. We're currently waiting for Minnesota Power to come and assist us with some overhead clearances. Jim, why don't you give us a little snapshot of the history and the evolution of the vision, which I believe you're the spearhead of the vision.
Well, I don't know if I'd call myself the spearhead. As a president, I guess I could take charge of it, but there's been a lot of people that have been active with this. But yeah, this this particular building was built in 1927. It was to house the car shop superintendent's office. And it was about maybe a half mile down. We've moved it off its foundation this morning. And, and it was March of 2010 when we were looking for a place to house our museum. And we found out that this building was going to be demolished by CN. They didn't need it anymore. And so we contacted Scott Roberts out of the CN headquarters in Chicago, is the branch there. And we've been working ever since to raise enough money to be able to move this building. And so that became a reality when we started our fundraising in May of 2010. And we had some major fundraisers and some major donors, especially Pat and Coke Emberg, who stepped forward with an initial $10,000, followed by a $25,000 match. And so we're sitting at $85,000 right now in our account, but going fast. And so we're going to have more money coming in as the time goes on. But by the end of the day, we're going to have it on site and off CN property. And it's a good day for railroad people across Proctor area.
Very good, Jim. It's quite a gift, quite a vision to capture a piece of history. It's going to be placed up next to the Malley steam engine. So it's got an existing parking lot, very, very accessible by the public. And some of the features inside are, we're going to have some historic model railroads for an interpretive center, and some of the original DMNIR Mesabi bridge documents.
Lots of things
to look at history and go back in time with.
Well, there's a lot of history here in Proctor. There was over 3,000 people were employed in Proctor at one time. This place of 85 miles of track. It was the world's largest ore sorting yard back during World War II. And about 85% of all the ore that was used to build the ships and the munitions for World War II came right through the Proctor Yard down to the shipyards and had to be sorted here. So this was a really important building, historically speaking, for the railroad. And the fact that now it doesn't have to be destroyed is even better for the next generations of people to see.
Jim, I just want to say thank you.
Thank you, Paul.
As a Proctor graduate, I'm proud to be involved with the community. And
this is great stuff.
We're at the halfway point here. Now we're going to have some more dynamic film coming, and so
we will.
It's going to be a full day.
It will be a full day.
Thanks again.
You bet, Paul.